Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the Arch of Destruction. Kind of a fancy name, but I think you'll see as we walk through some examples how important the sidewalls and the ceiling are to this situation. So the most ideal situation we can have in listening to two-channel music, whether it's monitoring in a mixing, mastering position, or anything else that deals with two channels, is to listen in free space. Well, free space means no rooms, no boundaries, no walls, no floors. Got to have floors, I guess. No ceiling. So no walls and no ceiling. So if we take our system outside and we listen to it without boundaries, we get a certain sound quality. We listen to it inside with room boundaries, then we have all kinds of issues. Thus the name Arch of Destruction, which, let me turn around here, which refers to our left side wall, our right side wall, and our ceiling. So it kind of forms an arch. So we have all of the issues now dealing with the ceiling and the two side walls, and a lot of people don't really understand this. So we're going to walk through some examples. Let me walk back over here. So we walk through removing the ceiling and the side walls, how we're going to get a different sound quality. And what's the attributes to all that? It's all about reflections. It's all about reflections and the time signature of those reflections from the side walls, from our left side wall, from our right side wall, from our ceiling. We have all of these reflections interplaying upon what we're doing. Floor also. All of these contribute to a certain sound quality. So we have to really work with the time signature of all of these reflections. And the ceiling to the floor is one of the most critical because we're sitting in our chair on the floor. So that boundary surface is critical. And then the ceiling is the next closest distance above the chair. So we have that to deal with. So we have floor and ceiling time signature. It's always a balance between the direct sound from our loudspeakers and the reflected energy from the room. So we always have this balance to achieve. So the treatments that we use to get this balance is critical. The rates and levels of absorption, and I see this all the time. One size does not fit all. Just because it's a sound absorbing material does not mean it's right in its application on your sidewall. Depends on distance, usage, driver size, distance to listening position, lots of variables to consider. So balancing the direct versus the reflected energy is very critical. What kind of reflections do we have from our side walls? We have the primary, which is this reflection here to the speaker off the closest boundary surface. Then that reflection travels across to the other wall. That's our secondary, and then that reflection travels back to its original wall. So we have all of these reflections going on. We have all of these balancing acts that we have to produce to balance all of these reflections with the direct sound from our speakers. So there we have it. We call it the Arch of Destruction. It's the sidewalls and the ceiling, and you really have to take special care in the treatment that you use to manage the balance between the direct and the reflected energy. Thank you. Hi everyone, thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website and there's a book now button so you can book a appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it because I need all that information when we talk. But I'll be happy to accommodate you. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.